Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to create a text box that auto-resizes itself based on the number of characters in your text layer. I'm also going to show you how to make your anchor point dynamic, which is huge. I use this expression every single day, and it keeps my anchor point centered in my text layer, despite the number of characters, lines, or words that there may be in that text layer. Now, these can be saved as presets, so it's not necessary to memorize a lot of complicated expressions. Just get it right the first time, save it as a preset, and then you can apply it in the future with the click of a button. If you're anything like me, these expressions will become a part of your everyday workflow. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. I'm going to just type my name, Jeff Knight, and I'm going to choose a little bit thicker font, and then I'm going to go ahead and center this up. So go to Transform, Center Anchor Point and Layer Content, or you can do Control Alt Home if you're on PC. I'm going to get my align panel out so that way it is completely centered. A few things with text that can be kind of annoying. If you adjust the size of your character, notice how your anchor point does not stay centered in our text. And this can be a problem depending on what you're doing, if you always need your anchor point to be centered. And then notice also, if you add more lines, if I start to type something else down here, if we click back on our text, we can see that our anchor point did not stay centered in our text. So the first thing I'm going to do is make our anchor point dynamic, meaning no matter what we do to this text, no matter how we scale it, no matter what we do to the character size, no matter how many lines we type, our anchor point will always stay centered. So I already have this script that I'm going to copy over, and I'm going to put it up here on the screen if you alt-click on anchor point, and we will just kind of go through this really quick. And then I will also put this script in the description, and I'm going to show you how to save it as a preset so you don't have to memorize this. You just have to get it right during this tutorial, and then once you save it as a preset, you can always just pop it on every text layer that you ever create, which is something I've been doing a lot lately. So our expression reads layer bound equals this layer dot source rect at time, then time inside your parentheses and a semicolon. Next line is T equals layer bound dot top semicolon. Next line, L equals layer bound dot left semicolon. Line 4 is W equals layer bound dot width semicolon. Fifth line is H equals layer bound dot height semicolon. And our last line is open bracket L plus W divided by 2, so slash 2, comma T plus H divided by 2. And we're going to close that bracket up. So we click on our text layer, we can see our anchor point right here is centered. Now watch, as we adjust our character size, the anchor point does not move. Let's go ahead and add that second line in, 7-minute, and then if we just click on it, we can see our anchor point is still centered. And if you noticed, our text actually moved as we start to type. So see, it is keeping our text completely centered in the middle of our composition. So this expression is extremely useful. A lot of times, I just pop it on a text layer as soon as I create the text layer. Highlight anchor point, go up to animation, save animation preset, make sure you're in your documents, Adobe, I'm in 2019, user presets, and I have this folder for 7-Minute AE, and I'm going to call this anchor point underscore dynamic. Just hit save for that. Okay, now let's just test this out. Alt-click on anchor point to get rid of it. You can see our anchor point moved right here. If you go to your effects and presets panel, you can actually type in anchor. We can see that our expression is right here where I saved it under my 7-minute AE folder. With this Jeff Knight layer highlighted, I'm going to double-click, and we can see it moved up slightly. And if you hit EE, there's our script. Once you apply this script to one layer of text, go ahead and save it as a preset so that way you never have to type it again. All you have to do is come over to your effects and presets panel and type in anchor, and then you'll see it. Okay, so the rest of this tutorial is going to focus on making a dynamic text box, but I wanted to create this dynamic anchor point so that way it can work in conjunction with our text box. So let's go to layer. We're going to add a new shape layer. We're going to pull it underneath our text layer, add a rectangle, and then we're going to add a fill. I'm going to just change this color a little bit. Now that we have our rectangle in here, we don't even have to resize it. I've got this script that we're going to put on the size of the rectangle path. So make sure you're putting it on the size of the rectangle path, not the transform scale. So if you open up rectangle path, I'll click on the size and type this along with me. We're going to go S equals, and then just go ahead and pick whip up to the Jeff Knight layer. So we get the rest of this line here, hit return, W equals S dot source. And if you're in After Effects 2019, one of the things After Effects will do as you start to type a script is it will give you some options of common scripts. So I'm going to take advantage of this and just arrow down to rect at time, hit return, then dot width. semicolon, and then we're going to go H equals S dot source. And again, I'm going to arrow down to rect at time dot height, semicolon. And then the last line, we're going to go open bracket WH. So if we click away, we can see that our box automatically resizes itself. Now notice though that our box is really tight around our text here. So the first way to kind of deal with this padding around our text, if we go into this WH layer, you can actually add in pixels. So say W plus 50, H plus 50, and that's just width and height. We're going to add 50 pixels. That's something you can do pretty quick. Another way to do it, which may be a lot easier, if you just highlight contents in your shape layer, go to add, and we're going to add an offset pass. And you can see it immediately kind of bumps it up. The reason why is because offset pass defaults to a value of 10. Click on contents. I'm going to go to animation, save animation preset. It's going to bring us back to the last folder we were in. And I'm going to call this text box dynamic. Save it. To see if it worked, let's click on contents and get rid of all that. Come back to our effects and presets panel, start typing text box, and we see it's right here under 7-Minute AE. Double click on that and see it popped right in. If you hit EE, something to take note of, with this script, you have to make sure this line right here, this inside of the quotation marks, is the same as your text line. And I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to take that script back off, and then let's just type something else, like another line. So now with our shape layer highlighted, if we double click this text box, we're going to get this error. And the reason why is because it's looking for the script we saved, which had Jeff Knight. So all you have to do is just go in here and change this to another line. And as you can see, I misspelled line. So just make sure that whatever your text line says right here in this first layer is the same thing that's in your script. And as you can see, it popped right in. You can say this as a preset, but just be mindful if you get an error that what this is looking for is whatever this line of text is called. And it doesn't really matter what the text is up here. It matters what the text is on your layer. Because see, watch, if I highlight our text layer and just hit return, so I'm not changing the text, I'm changing the name of the line, I can say name goes here. And even though I have Jeff Knight up here, if my layer says name goes here, that's what has to be in this script. And let me go ahead and just show you some of the things we can do with it. So like if I type my wife's name, notice how the box resizes itself. Now that we have that dynamic anchor point, I can even add in more text and our box will reshape itself and our anchor point will stay centered. So no matter how many lines I type on this, our box will always resize itself to our text and our text will always stay centered. So this is a very, very useful expression. It's a very useful thing to do whenever you're doing text box animation. One of the things I highly recommend that you do whenever you have text on a box is go to your effects and presets and pull up set mat. Go ahead and just add a set mat to that. And then you want to set the mat to the shape layer. And the reason why is because now, see, I can animate this up onto the box and the set mat will only reveal it whenever it's inside of this area here. So one of the things you need to be careful of, obviously, is parenting these layers to one another. What I recommend you do is go layer, new null object, and see it's going to pop right here in the center of our comp right here, and just parent these two layers to your null object. Rename that to text controller. So now you can do whatever you need to do with these layers. Say, for example, what if I wanted to animate this on, but I don't want it to affect my text layer? Well, now that it's parented to that null object, we can just animate this on and it's fine. We can also grab our text layer. We can do something with that. We can animate that on. So that's my recommendation, is that instead of parenting these layers to one another, you actually parent them to a null object and you use that to control your text. I hope that helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. I would love to get your feedback about this episode and also hear about any topic you would like to see covered. And don't forget to check out my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers every aspect of shape layers. The link to that course, as well as to the project files for this episode, are in the description below. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time.